Hello, welcome back to the Press On Coffee channel. Today we're fitting our water tanks with Uniseal fittings. The Uniseal fittings are a rubber gasket that you can pretty much install in any type of tank. And the reason I got these Uniseal fittings is because the water tanks I ordered came pre-installed with four or three half-inch fittings each on each one, and then two vent pipes. But little did I know, I should have had them install one of those fittings on each tank to be like an inch and a half or inch and a quarter for fill and for drain, faster drain and faster fill. Okay, so let's get to it. So right now I'm trying to finish up with connecting my drain lines to my gray water tank here. So this Uniseal is what it's called. This is, I guess, created by an aquarium company, but this can pretty much be installed in any surface. So it's pretty impressive. Fast fitting too, so you're not worried about spin welding fittings onto your tank, and you need special bits and tools for that anyway. And you just take a hole saw for the size that you have. So I got an inch and a quarter hole saw for this 3/4 inch Uniseal. And then this seal, you just push it into the tank, and then you'll take your fitting. I have a 3/4 inch female fitting here. Once you push it all the way in, it creates a watertight seal just from pressure on that Uniseal. I was really skeptical about it, but saw videos on YouTube, people using it in RVs, marine applications for boats and so forth. Yeah, first one went in pretty easy, so I thought I'd show you how it works. Mark my spot where it's gonna go. You could probably use a paddle bit if you wanted to, but if you use a paddle bit, you're gonna get a lot more shavings inside your tank. This is nice because it catches that chunk. But yeah, so I'll rinse this, of course, before I hook it up all the way, get the debris out. Okay, so there's my hole. Here's the Uniseal. It's bigger than, of course, the hole, so you're just gonna push this in there. Once that's in there, it's snug. Probably not coming out very easily without cutting it out. Now I have this 3/4 inch fitting, and it's gonna just shove right in there. And that's gonna make it even tighter. Now, how this works too, pressure from this presses against here, so it makes a tighter seal, but also the pressure from the tank forces this too kind of outward, which puts pressure on this inner seal. That took a little force and twisting to get it in there, so you know it's snug, but now I got two in there. I'm just gonna cap this one off. This is my inlet to my whole trailer. So right here, I'm gonna install this Uniseal. This Uniseal is 1.5 inches. It requires a 2.5 inch hole saw. This 2.5 inch hole saw definitely had more, you know, grab to it, being a bigger hole. So it did give me as clean as a hole as I wanted to, but that's okay. I just took my razor knife and trimmed off any burrs and a little bit of sandpaper to smooth it out a bit. Okay, I got just the smallest bit of dish soap here. I'm gonna put just lubricate around this, maybe inside the seal a little bit. Okay, that just took a little bit of manpower, elbow grease, but it's in there. And then we will pipe thread this guy, probably put some pipe seal it on too, just to be safe.
This will be connected outside. This will go from here to here. Cool.
This is the fill dish. This is kind of the last puzzle piece to it all. I'll put this on the outside of the trailer. Basically operates the same as a gas tank. Pretty big inlet, just so the water flows freely and easily into your freshwater tank. Hopefully we'll get to pour our first cup of coffee soon and test all the equipment and blowing out. Again, my name is Gerard with Press On Coffee. Thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe, like the video, and leave comments if you have any questions. And stay tuned next week when we cut out our service window and install that. We'll see you next time.